We are posting this video a little early on Monday evening, actually, for our Tuesday encouragement. But I had asked the folks on Sunday to join us this Tuesday for a day of fasting and prayer for spiritual renewal in our nation. And I read the account of a man by the name of Fred Lunsford, who is a retired pastor, and he's 95 years old, and he has been praying for the past couple years for a spiritual renewal in America. And he asked some preachers to join him on May the 5th, 2020, to go up on the mountain with him and pray with him. And they first tried to get 10 preachers, and that quickly grew to 100, and then that soon grew to 200. And because of the pandemic, they were unable to travel and to be able to go and be with him on that day. And so he put out a plea to churches to have Christians to join in praying concerning a spiritual renewal in the United States of America. And I believe there's over 198,000 people who have signed up, committed that they would join in prayer. And I ask our church to join also. So would you make Tuesday, this day, a day of fasting and prayer? The church will be open at 6 a.m. in the morning, and we will keep it open throughout the day. You can come at any time and just come in and pray. You can pray at the altar or be seated in the pews and pray. And let's pray for that spiritual awakening, that spiritual renewal in our nation and even in our own lives. God said, if I send pestilence among my people, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Oh, that God would heal our land, that God would take away this pestilence that's among us, and that God would bring healing to those who are sick, but that God would bring healing to our hearts, and that Christians and unsaved alike would be turned to God. And so as we spend this day in prayer and fasting, would you make plans? Would you make a commitment yourself to spend some time praying for our nation? I encourage you to do so. And we sure miss you here at the church. We love you. And we're looking forward to the day when we can all be back together again soon. May God bless you and meet every need in your life.